loans up to 1 crore rupees for MSMEs. Within 59 minutes through a dedicated online portal, under the interest subvention scheme for MSMEs, 350 crores of rupees has been allocated for the year 2019-20 for 2% interest subvention for all GST registered MSMEs on fresh or on incremental loans. Government payments to suppliers and contractors are a major source of cash flow, especially to SMEs and MSMEs. Investment in MSMEs will receive a big boost if these delays in payment are eliminated. Government will create a payment platform for MSMEs to enable filing of bills and payment thereof on the platform itself, thereby cutting down the time and the process itself. Encouraged by the overwhelming response, the Government of India has decided to extend the pension benefit to about 3 crore retail traders and shopkeepers whose annual turnover is less than 1.5 crores under a new scheme, namely Pradhan Mantri Karam Yogi Man Dhan scheme. Enrollment into the scheme will be kept simple, requiring only Aadhaar and a bank account, and the rest will be on self-declaration. We recognize that investment-driven growth requires access to low-cost capital. It is estimated that India requires investments averaging 20 lakh crores of rupees every year. A number of measures are proposed to enhance the sources of capital for infrastructure financing. A credit guarantee enhancement corporation, for which regulations have been notified by the RBI, will be set up in 2019-20. An action plan to deepen the market for long-term bonds, including for deepening markets for corporate bond repos, credit default swaps, etc., with specific focus on infrastructure sector, will be put in place. It is proposed to permit investments made by FIIs and FPIs in debt securities issued by infrastructure debt fund, non-bank finance companies, the IDFs, NBFCs, to be transferred, sold to any domestic investor within specified lock-in period. Corporate debt markets are crucial for the infrastructure sector. Given the need to further deepen bond markets, a number of measures are proposed to be taken up. To deepen the corporate tri-party repo market in corporate debt securities, government will work with regulators, the RBI and the SEBI, to enable stock exchanges to allow AA-rated bonds as collaterals. User-friendliness of trading platforms for corporate bonds will be reviewed, including issues arising out of capping of International Security Identification Number, the ISIN. It's right time to consider increasing minimum public shareholding in the listed companies. I have asked SEBI to consider raising the current threshold of 25% to 35%. As a key source of capital to the Indian economy, it is important to ensure a harmonized and hassle-free investment experience for foreign portfolio investors. Hence, it is proposed to rationalize and streamline the existing Know Your Customer, the KYC norms, for FPIs to make it more investable.